And we're back with another episode of The Whispered World. Blind, I'm the RPG chick. We've just made our way into this room. Oh, like the frog we had to throw in the soup to feed the horn-eyed guy. Ugh.
This is the uglier of the two trophies. No, I take that back. This trophy is really the uglier one. I can't make up my mind. They're both ugly, that's for sure.
Yeah, they're tied.
Oh my, you are ugly.
I thought I was going to answer.
I can't reach it, which isn't a bad thing at all. This is the uglier of the two trophies. No, this trophy...
I was going to say the same thing.
They're both ugly. Oh my, you are ugly.
It's the other valve.
I can't reach it, which isn't a bad thing at all.
Before we raise the water level, let's check everything in here. This door.
This door is significantly... door-ish. I should write that incredible discovery down in my diary. What's this? No insuperable lock? No complicated mechanism? Are you sure you're a door at all?
Okay, well that works. What's that? A fork thing. Fork thing.
What is this? Some kind of fork? The Asgil have quite a lot of cutlery lying around.
Hey, they like to eat. And kill people.
From what I know,
eat them.
This is not a tuning fork.
We gotta look at this thing. Oh, okay.
Almost cozy, if it wasn't for the fact that an Asgil is likely to show up any minute to throw me in. Oh dear.
God.
That didn't help at all. Darn asthmatic lungs.
It sounded spooky, actually.
Empty.
Well, we can use Spot to light the chimney if we needed to. Another one. There's two of those stone desks. Nothing here on the table for us to look at? That's surprising.
Another one of those peculiar secret passage gongs. I need some kind of...
We have a beater. We turn the valve.
There's a lock on the valve's control wheel. My teeth aren't strong enough for that. I'd really like to, but it's locked.
No, I have to see if he says something different every time. Key.
Some kind of a valve. I wonder what it's for. My teeth aren't strong enough for that. That's not necessary. It's already turned up to max. It's warm enough.
Okay. Oh, wait.
I need some kind of a...
We have a beater. The door is closed and we're getting opening door sounds. Same place. Did the water level rise though? Oh wait. I want the last door. I want to see if the water level rose. In. Huh. Oh! Oh wow.
Level is way up. The mechanism should work now.
What's the lever for?
It's much too high to reach. Like the goal as I've set myself.
Can we take the rope now?
No need. I'm done here.
What is this powering? Is it powering the rooms? Thumbs up with this door, man. Let's try this way twice. Maybe this one doesn't work yet. Maybe I should go back to the other room. Let's try banging it twice. Nope. Okay.
It's locked.
That's locked now? Well, hold on. I've got a key. I mean, it's locked.
It's locked.
All right, well. Still asleep? Surprised all the rumbling and stuff didn't wake him up. So now what do we do? Oh, it's blocked off. Wow. Huh. We need to turn the stuff back.
That's not necessary. It's already turned up to max. Empty.
I'm just messing around with this stuff, guys. I don't know.
It's locked.
That door is gone, but what about... the window. Alright, the door's... oh, we can go in now. Still can't reach the friggin' bucket.
I can't reach it.
When there's no door here, what about the window? What will we see through there? So I gotta move the room back, right? Oh, wrong one. Well, it gets us over there quicker. I guess it's not moving that room, it's moving the first room with the war plans and stuff. I want to get there quicker. I don't think that made a difference. Oh, the window? There's no even a window there. Which one do I want again? I want this one. I'm not sure. Okay. Now there's no door, but there's a window. What will we see inside? Maybe we could send Spot through? Oh, we're on this window? Can we reach the bucket now? Then we could stand on it and pull that lever and see what the hell happens.
That looks useful. Too bad I can't reach it. Why must everything always be out of reach? I can't reach it.
Can we almost reach it? Can we reach it with this?
I can't reach it.
Damn.
That could actually work.
Oh god, now I gotta go back around.
There's a hole in the bucket, dear Henry, dear Henry. There's a hole in... I can't reach it.
Yeah, now what? Trying to think here. I don't know if there's another one I could be messing with. But every time you hear that door noise, something changed. The door's back. Yay, the bucket. Take. Hooray! We got bucket.
There's a hole in.
Oh god, shut up. Sorry guys, this must be extremely boring watching him slowly walk from side to side and walking all over the place. But we did accomplish something, we got the bucket. And now if we can stand on it, I can pull that lever. Let's see what happens there. I just want to place the bucket. What if I put the bucket on spot? Not what I intended to do.
There's a hole in. There's a hole in the bucket.
Oh. Say anything new.
There's a hole.
But we got fork and bucket. I would have just stood on the bucket.
The bucket isn't heavy enough to engage the lever. Why must everything always be out of reach? It's much too high to reach. Like the goal as I've set myself.
It's still too high to reach.
Spot is too heavy to throw that far.
Oh, let's make him not heavy.
Spot is too heavy to throw that far.
Still too heavy? We throw a bunch of spots? Oh, we put him in the bucket. Now we can make him into a heavy spot.
The bucket isn't heavy.
Heavy sport. Ha!
What's that? An elevator?
Huh?
Let's see. dizzying heights, and he's being driven by a complicated mechanism. Yeah, this escape road has been made especially for me. Oh, I want to go back to my cell.
Lols. We can go up now, yay! Anything else to see in this place? Do we need the rope for anything? I want to take that rope back.
No need.
Alright.
I still can't believe I was able to get away from them.
You mean we did it?
Corona. How should I ever reach that place?
I don't know, I guess start by going that way.
The Asgil lift down there. I still can't believe I was able to get away from them.
So all that just to make this elevator work again.
That was even less entertaining than I expected. Jumping is not the answer. Do you hear, Shadwick? Don't do it.
No, don't do it. It's much higher over there.
I'm getting all dizzy thinking that I used that thing.
Here I thought we were going to raise the water level and drown the entire village, killing the Asgil.
I think I bit my tongue riding up here. It's good that I'm not poisonous.
Poisonous to yourself?
I won't go back down there again. One attempt to escape the Asgil is enough.
Oh, you pick up more rocks, useful things.
I'm not saying anything derisive now. After all, stones have proven to be quite useful during the course of my journey. No thanks. I already feel as if I have stones in my stomach.
You're a hypochondriac too? Look at all these useful items. Alright. To new territory. Oh, hello. Garden, birds, station agent. Oh, the pantaloons. We keep finding those. Clothesline, a shirt, and tracks. Oh, we gotta take the train. More tracks.
Those tracks don't really inspire confidence. Where do these tracks lead?
They used to go straight to Corona, but
oh, hello.
The line has been discontinued.
Oops. That's not helpful.
I don't think anyone will see me if I wave.
Yeah. I don't think anyone will hear me if I call out.
Where do these tracks...
No. Hey, you got the line!
I suppose I get the same response here.
Those tracks don't... Where do these
They use the light!
I don't think anyone will see me if I wave.
Garden.
There's nothing growing here at all.
Hey! Are you referring to my height?
Shoot!
No.
No, I wasn't. I'm not even much good at innuendo anymore.
Sheesh. Touchy.
Hey! Keep your hands off my pumpkin bed!
Hey! Do you have to stand up every time you talk?
Hey!
The birds look quite comfortable there. It could be difficult to scare them away from the flower bed. Shoo! That'd be a first if somebody actually did what I say. Shoo!
Hey, you! Keep your pet away from my beds! I have to deal with enough vermin as it is.
Okay. A shirt.
Extra, 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 extra small. How cute. Is this your shirt, or do you have a toy poodle?
Don't get fresh with me, chum! Keep your hands off my laundry.
Yeah. Guy's bossy.
The inscription on my tombstone will read, though he could not save the world, his knowledge of the regional clotheslines was excellent. This clothesline looks like Grandpa's dental floss. It's the moss growing on it that does it.
Hey!
Yeah. Now these are mine. Or, well,
those
Grandpa's.
Those must be Grandpa's pantaloons again. How on earth did they get here? How did you come across those pantaloons over there?
Actually, that's a strange story. And pretty embarrassing. So the truth goes with me to my grave.
That can be arranged, Bob.
Hey!
Alright, so let's talk to this guy. Or look at him.
He's a mean fellow. I could easily put him into my pocket, but I'm afraid he'd bite me.
He probably would.
Hey there.
Stop it, you scatterwags. Not half a step further.
What? Can you help me?
Can you help me?
That depends. With what?
I will destroy the world. I have to get to Corona really fast.
I have to get to Corona really fast.
To Corona? Forget it. The train doesn't go there anymore.
A train? What train are you talking about?
I told you to forget it. The line has been discontinued. You'd better find another way.
The train tracks we were looking at. Sadwick, focus. What other way is there to Corona?
What other way is there to Corona?
To be honest, the train was the only way to Corona. But I already told you, it doesn't go there anymore.
Can we just walk on the tracks or something? Everything is so horrible.
Everything is so horrible. The Asgil want to attack Corona? The world will end? And it's all my fault!
Oh boy. What kind of a wuss are you? If I were your world, I'd rather end myself. And that's a fact.
With a clown kind of wuss. I've got Asgil hot on my trail.
I've got Asgil hot on my trail.
The Asgil can come if they want. I'm prepared for that.
You're through with life?
No. I've placed some traps.
I'm forced to talk to wound-up screwballs all the time.
I'm forced to talk to wound-up screwballs all the time.
Really? I hardly ever have to do that. This week has been the first time, actually.
And I will destroy the world.
I will destroy the world.
Well, that's what I want to. So what? But take my advice. Don't spread that around. People don't really appreciate that kind of thing.
You can't help me. Nobody can.
You can't help me. Nobody can.
I think so, too. The way you're dressed. Is there anything else? You're blocking the view of my favorite tree.
What? So there's a train?
There's a train?
Don't you ever listen? I told you, there's no train. The locomotive still stands up there. But it hasn't moved in a long time.
May I take a look at the locomotive?
May I take a look at the locomotive?
Well, that's rich. Do I look like a museum? I told you, there's no train. On the other hand, the idea isn't too bad. I wonder what I could charge for an entrance fee.
How'd you come across those pantaloons over there?
How did you come across those pantaloons over there?
Actually, that's a strange story. And pretty embarrassing. So the truth goes with me to my grave.
Okay. Well, the idea of the railroad museum has something to it.
But the idea of the railroad museum has something to it.
Yeah. But the entrance fee, would it in fact pay off? I'm not sure about it.
We don't have money. Where's this saying red scent come from anyway? Why is this red scent? Covered with blood, so it's useless? I wouldn't want to pay more than 5 pieces of silver.
I wouldn't want to pay more than 5 pieces of silver.
Only 5? We don't have a deal then. 5 measly pieces of silver. I couldn't even buy a new roll of tickets for that.
I might be willing to spend a gold coin.
I might be willing to spend a gold coin.
Only one? For a visit to Maurice's majestic railroad museum, that has to be worth more.
Okay, I wouldn't spend a red cent then. Let me in.
I wouldn't spend 1 red cent on that.
You're probably right. Opening a museum was probably a crackpot idea.
But the idea...
Would it... I'm not...
I'd even pay 10 gold coins for something as great as that. Now I gotta find 10 gold coins.
I'd even pay 10 gold coins for something as great as that.
Honestly? You think people would pay that much to see a discarded locomotive?
Well, it's not just any old locomotive. In fact, it went to Corona, didn't it? So it's a royal locomotive.
Royal? That means I've been sitting on a gold mine all the time.
And you didn't even notice.
How could I have been so blind?
Luckily, you've proven your infallible business sense in the end.
You could say that again. I almost missed a lifetime opportunity here. Come here, people from far and near. Starting today, Maurice's Majestic Railroad Museum has opened.
May I take a look at the locomotive now?
May I take a look at the locomotive now?
Sure. That's 10 gold coins. Do you have the money?
Not exactly. Actually, I don't have any money on me.
Well, then, back off. You're blocking the entrance for the other customers.
What other customers? How's business with the museum?
What? How's business with the museum?
I haven't had a single customer. What am I doing wrong?
I have a couple ideas on what to improve. It's been like a minute.
I have a couple of ideas on what to improve.
Oh yeah? And why should I listen to you? It's not like you're
my advisor smart.
Or anything.
You could hire me as an advisor.
Well, why not? All right. You'll get 1 gold coin a day after the work is done. So, go ahead. What do you suggest?
You could lower the prices?
You could lower the prices?
Never! A visit to Maurice's Majestic Railroad Museum is worth 10 gold coins.
You should change the name.
You should change the name.
Should I really?
Definitely. Maurice's Majestic Railroad Museum sounds way too pompous.
What do you suggest?
It doesn't seem more than a Maurice's mini museum.
It doesn't seem more than a Maurice's mini museum.
Mini museum? Is that meant to be an innuendo?
Believe me, people like small things. They'll beat a path to your door.
Okay. We'll change the name. Do you have any more suggestions?
Maybe it's because of the grumpy members of staff.
Maybe it's because of the grumpy members of staff?
What do you think? When I look at you, you're probably right. You look like someone has ridden you.
You mean bitten?
I meant what I said. What do you suggest?
First, you should fire the grumpy manager.
First, you should fire the grumpy manager.
I can only do that with 3 months' notice.
That's a shame.
You should introduce staff discount.
You should introduce, staff discount.
Staff discount? No way.
Why not? Look at it this way. You'd make your staff happy and still get money from them.
What? Hey, you're right. Those morons.
Oh, complete idiots.
All right, it's a deal.
That's some laugh.
Members of staff get a 50% discount.
Cool. Now I only need 5 gold coins. You should hire a jester?
You should hire a jester.
A jester? Have you gone mad?
Hey, I happen to know the staff pretty well. I don't want to scare you, but if they don't get some entertainment soon, they may go on strike.
A strike? All right, but where could I get a jester?
You can't do the job yourself.
Why not? Do you think I'm not... I can't jest?
When shall I start?
Right away.
Great.
You'll get one gold coin a day after the work is done.
All right. Or, it'll pick up eventually.
I think so, too. I'll give a motivating speech during the Christmas party, and the problem will solve itself.
You should take down all the laundry.
You should take down all the laundry. It doesn't fit the good name of your museum.
What good name are you talking about? It's Maurice's mini-museum. People can think themselves lucky they can stand upright while they look at the locomotive.
Those birds in the front yard are spoiling the aesthetics.
Those birds in the front yard are spoiling the aesthetics. It doesn't fit the good name of your museum.
What good name are you talking about? It's Maurice's mini-museum. People can think themselves lucky they can stand upright while they look at the locomotive.
I can't think of anything else.
I can't think of anything.
What kind of an advisor have I hired? You better come up with something or I'll cut your pay.
What about my pay?
What about my pay?
Let's see. You are my advisor, and you are my jester. So you've already earned 2 gold coins. I'll keep the money until after you've finished work.
May I take a look at the locomotive now?
May I take a look at the locomotive now?
Sure. That's 6 gold coins.
Do 6?
Do you have the money?
Not exactly. Couldn't I just take it out of my salary?
Maybe that'll work. First, we have to look at what we've earned so far.
Well?
You are my advisor, and you are my jester. So you've already earned 2 gold coins.
Well,
that doesn't seem to be enough. What a shame. You would have been my first customer.
I thought I'd get a 50% discount. With 10 gold coins, that would be 5 then.
I have another piece of advice I could give you.
So let's have it. I'm paying you for this after all.
What's that?
I can't think of anything.
What kind of an advisor have I hired? You better come up with something or I'll cut your pay.
I don't have any time for conversation.
You sure talk a lot for someone who hasn't got time.
I think maybe we need to get rid of the birds. Alright. Stay tuned for the next episode, guys. This is a rather long one. Hopefully you get to see the locomotive next time. I will think on what to do here. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And a bang bang boogie. And don't stop the boogie.